And that opens up a whole thing.
Yeah.
How do we view the world, and what effect has one point framed perspective had on our view of the world, which opens up a whole can of worms. Interesting ones, though. And the action of actually looking and drawing is that you have to trust that your body's going to connect up and come up with something. And most of the time, I think when we're checking, the eyes are sort of checking, is that right? Is it equivalent to that? And of course, it can't be anyway. A drawing is not reality. It's another reality. So it depends whether you want to make something look like it or whether you want it to be like it. Mm-hmm. They're two different things. So what this does as well is force you into things about scale and sight size. So when you're just drawing from sight, what I find is like you're drawing there, my figures fill the page. And when I'm drawing in the camera, suddenly the figures are like this big. I'm like going, oh, but you know, but I want to do that. But if I do that, I'm off the body. So it's really, really, and a lot of you were doing that, weren't you? You were sort of off the body a bit, even in the camera, because it's a natural thing. And there's something about the way we see and the scale we draw at, and the way a lens sees and the scale it makes things. And they're different.
I just felt a bit like my intended view with this one.
Yeah.
And I like science fiction, so I had to be Yoda. Don't think, just do. That's how I started drawing on this one, because I just didn't have a cat because I'm not started to be around. This
worked.
Yeah.
Once you get your brain out of the way, that one's okay, isn't it? But it messes with.
Does. It's like someone puts a shield over your head and you just have to trust that. Without you actually drawing it.
Yeah. It shifts your eyes from policing to being more of a messenger, and I think that's kind of freeing, you know, because normally your eyes are kind of policing, oh, it doesn't look good, or that line's not right, to just relaying messages about, okay, I think it's there. It feels really interesting.
In Amarillo, that reminded me of took me back to in South Africa. I took flying lessons, but of helicopter flying lessons. And they're one of the things you've got two controls, the pitch of the yaw here and the forward and backwards. You have to think in 3D. And the instructor was always shouting at me not to look at the controls where my hand was. He says, you've got to look through the front and pick a spot in space, and based on that, calibrate the movement. And that completely messed with my head, you know, and it took me back to that, because I have a real problem with the relativity of the movements of my hands and what I'm seeing in actual space. And it took me back to that. I found that the hardest thing to do. And it would be interesting for you to do that with helicopter pilots. Find helicopter pilots, see whether they have that ability, because I'm sure they really do have that ability to control their hands independent but reliant on what they're seeing as opposed to.